nothing but a hound dog. You cry all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Crying all the time. Well, you ain't never caught a rabbit and you ain't no friend of mine. Well, they said you was high class. Well, that was just a lie. Yeah, they said you was high class.
Kidney surgery on Monday.
Oh wow! I hope it goes well.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, hey Ryan.
Hey Ryan.
Hey guys. Hey, Mr. Budapay wants to see me in his office.
Okay, thanks.
Come in.
Morning, Mr. B.
Hey Ryan, just the guy I wanted to see. Have a seat. Hey, got some good news. Got some bad news. Which one do you want to hear first?
I guess the bad news first, so then the good news can heal the wound.
Well. Bad news is, I'm going to have to ask you to pack up all your things. Good news, I want you to pack them all up and move up to your brand new office.
Really?
Well, you know about the new position. Comes with a company card, new office, and to tell you the truth, I've been impressed with your work lately. Position's yours if you want it.
Yes, sir. I'd be honored. Of course, sir.
Good. Then it's settled. Welcome to the higher-ups.
Thank you, sir.
Ryan?
Yes, sir.
You can go now.
Oh, of course, sir. Sorry.
Hey, are we still on for our date tonight?
I don't know. Let me check. Yeah.
Okay, sounds good. I'll pick you up like at 6:30, okay?
Okay, sounds good.
All right, see you then.
Bye.
Hey, Levi. What do you want?
Did you hear about my brother?
No, what happened?
He got promoted to chief operating officer.
What? I worked really hard for that position.
Yeah, well, that's how I came to you. You're really good with computers, right?
Yeah, but I had to stop doing that stuff in order to keep this job. Remember?
Yeah, but you still want that position, right?
Yeah, but?
But what? It's pretty simple. Think about it.
I guess so.
Come on. I have an idea.
Okay, not a word anywhere about me doing this.
Right. And no leaving a trace back to us?
Of course. Alright, so what do you have?
So I have some good news.
Oh, what is it?
I got a job promotion at work, so I'm officially the COO of Edison Paper Manufacturing, Inc.
That's great!
That's not all, though. Now that I got the job promotion, I can do something I've been wanting to do for a really long time.
Macy Roxanne Dunfield, I love you, and I want to spend the rest of my life with you. Will you marry me? Marry me?
Yes.
Alright, Stevie, let's do this.
Okay, boss.
Now remember, you're transferring 15% of the profits made by the company over into Ryan's personal bank account.
Alright, I got this.
Alright, go.
And done. I've automated the system so I will automatically send the profits straight to his account.
Great, let's get out of here.
You will never guess what he uses for his password.
What?
His birthday. I mean, who does that?
Shh.
Mr. Budapay? Yeah.
I have some bad financial news.
Well, you're the chief accountant. Have a seat. Tell me what's going on.
It appears that we've lost a large sum of money all of a sudden.
Stolen?
Yes.
Well, are there any leads to where it went?
Yes, it was led to Ryan's account.
Right. Your brother, Ryan?
Yes, sir.
I see, Levi. Thank you. Hey, do me a favor. Send Ryan in here.
Yes, sir.
So today's the big day for you, huh?
Yeah, I'm actually kind of nervous.
Don't worry. These are some of the finest surgeons in the state. Oh, congratulations on your engagement.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, also, Mr. B wants to see you in his office. Probably another promotion.
I hope so. Thanks, guys.
See ya.
Hey, Mr. B.
Come in, Ryan. Sit down. Listen, Ryan. You know I trust you more than most people in this company, but... Well, we've got some evidence that shows you've taken a fair amount of company funds, and they've ended up in your personal account.
That's impossible. I've never done anything like that in my entire life.
I'm sorry, Ryan, but we've got the evidence already. I'm going to have to ask you to turn back in those company car keys and pack up your stuff. I need you out of the office today.
But Mr. Budapest, I didn't even...
No, don't worry about it. I need you to leave now.
Work. I've been talking to my dad, and I told him what happened, and he recommended that I call off the engagement until you can support a family. I'm sorry, but I can't go through with the engagement at this time because you aren't in the position to support us. Goodbye, Ryan.
Sorry it's such a mess. I've basically been living in my car since Rachel hasn't been too happy with me.
I'm just glad I could get a ride. I'd probably get hit by a truck if I was walking.
Yeah.
So aside from Rachel kicking you out, how's your life going?
You know, just more work stuff and... Yeah, what's that? How's this job interview? Is it good for you?
Yeah, I think I got the job actually.
Great. It's amazing.
So how did Robert's surgery go?
I don't know. I haven't seen him since Monday. Hey, Ryan, I gotta tell you something.
Yeah, what's up?
I was the one who framed you. I was just jealous, because I thought Mr. Budapest was playing favorites and...
You're joking, right? This is a joke? Because this isn't funny.
No, I'm not joking. I just...
You're serious?
Yes.
How could you do that to me?
Oh, I'm...
My own brother. I trusted you. And you just stabbed me in the back?
I was just jealous, because... Yeah, I don't know.
Pull the car over. I'm walking the rest of the way.
No, I'm going to take you to your interview. I don't want you to go over there by yourself.
So you care if I walk to my job interview, but not when my entire livelihood's on the line?
Well, I'm...
Do you know what you did to my life? How you destroyed it?
Well, I... No. That's not it.
Does Mr. Budapest know what you've done?
No, I haven't told him or anybody else. I wanted to tell you first.
So you not only destroy my life,
But you keep it to yourself so you don't get in trouble for what you did?
I know how it seems, and I know I messed up badly, but...
Levi, watch out!
Are you Mr. Edison?
I am. You must be Jeremy.
Yeah, I am.
Please, have a seat. So, tell me about yourself.
Well, I'm 12 years old. I live with my mom, my brother, and my sister. My brother always gets me in trouble. He does it on purpose, and yes, I react, but I can't help it. He just makes me so angry.
Tell me something, Jeremy. Have you forgiven your brother?
No. Why should I? I've never done anything to him. He always does it for no good reason. So why should I?
You know, there was a point in my life when I felt the same way. Let me tell you about it.